Welcome, MFL viewers, to Too Big to Fail Financial Stadium, built on money from a loan that can't possibly be paid back. And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Brain Washington Cadavers take on the Philadelphia Eagles. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Are you ready for some MFL action?
Am I? I love MILFs. Mutants I'd like to fuck.
He said MFL, not M-I-L-F, you halfwit.
Ow! I thought you were talking about the Mayhem Bowl halftime MILF lingerie girls team. What a zombie QB with that big rack of ribs and almost no waist at all. Ho-ho! Va-va-va-voom!
And it's first and 10. Man, what a hit that was! And it's first and 10. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter. That'd be fantastic.
And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. Roid rage. Because if you can't answer your question with violence, ask another. Reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. First down and 3. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. That'll bring up 2nd and 1. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Hey.
And they line up for the extra point. Feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's 1st and 10. Partner. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's 1st and 10. What?
I mean, first down!
What the hell was that?
I honestly don't know, Grim.
Oh, a second there. Second down and 10. Whoa, and he laterals the ball to the player behind him. Third down and, well, good luck.
Receiver runs away from the pass marker? That's a good clue that something's not right.
Now here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. With a brutal hit. Second down and 9. That's about a 3-yard pickup. Third down and 5. Loves punishing the defenders. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Destruction in his path. And the, oh, and that's when it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out again, I'd have to make it to Dice Grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Second down and a lot. Trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose!
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's first and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone. And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appeared to be cheating. He's just making shit up. And this is a first and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. First down and forever. And the defense gave up a lot of yards on that pass play. They'll need to regroup quickly. Second down and 6. It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. Second down and 6. Huh? It's first and ten. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights.
I think I shine my car.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and ten. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and six. Third down and long. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and ten. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast, dirty trick, and throws a supersonic.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team.
How have they not killed him yet? He's wearing a new mink coat, for God's sake.
He's seven layers of smarmy, Grim.
They're back up here on first. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down in a mile. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And the QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy's full on berserk. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. And it's first and ten. And they run it for a couple of yards. And that'll be second and eight to go.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and ten. On that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and six. And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downish guy than a speed thing, Grim. He's running from his dangerous speed.
It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole.
Second down and 10.
Let me tell you, getting shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wool socks, slide around on a shag carpet for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel and got blown across the room.
First and 10. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. The way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
Second down and 5. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it. Third and 2. And that is caught for a first down. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? Your clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the NFL, you moron.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And that's a first down. Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. Ah, yes. You can tell this one must have just ended and burst forth from the chest of a wonderful chorus dancer. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't kick, but he sure can swat.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off-season.
Third and two. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stupsing time.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries. Makers of great killer products like Roundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. The third quarter is about to start as the teams take the field. This game has been one lopsided rout.
Yeah, football games are kind of like boobs. Big or small, they're both great. Except for when they're lopsided.
This one deserves some bonus time.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Briggs. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And it's first and ten. Just some good old downhill running there as he picks up the first down. First and ten. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and ten. Second down and seven. Oh, and the defender cut off that pass like a suburban mom on the way to speak to the manager. And he sure got...
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
First and ten. Second down and long. Nice run for a first down. And it's first and ten. This is your brain, and this is your brain. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
They might catch him.
Move, you fat little mutant.
The ten.
Go!
Thank you. ever do that again, Bricks, I'll shoot you in the head.
But people like it!
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick. First and 10. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And he was stuck to him like glue. And they'll line up for the punt here. Cut off bison head in his bed tonight. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
This guy's going to get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and 10.
You ever get hit? Wow, he took like 1,000 volts of shock there. They did that to my Aunt Lizzie because she thought she was the reincarnation of Lizzie Borden, the axe murderer.
Did the shock treatment work?
Well, after she killed 4 of the doctors and zapped her, they never bothered her again. So, yeah, I guess it worked for her.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10.
How do you miss a bomb kill right in someone's face? This your first time playing the game? Hey, you with the controller in your hand. I'm talking to you.
Second down and 10. First down! And this guy is a stud, Bricks.
Yeah, telling me! Nice run!
No, I mean, he's a real stud. He works at the Mutant Stud Farm weekends and summers.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
First down and 3. Kaboom! And oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown!
Yeah.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and ten. Oh, what a brutal hit! The team getting penalized needs to go into their dirty tricks and attack the ref. Come on, guys, get with it.
Attack him and kill him. Jeez.
First down and long. And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. Second down in a very lot. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Third down and eight. You've got to catch that. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he put all of his foot into that one. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and ten. Time like a jack in the box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is gonna blow. You just crap your pants, Junior. And it's first and ten. Normally that would be a first down, but he had a whole lot of ground to make up. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Man, what what a hit that was. And it's first and 10. No one was interested in that incomplete pass.
Not a ball's feelings are hurt.
Hey, don't make me explain that balls don't have emotions again, all right? Second down and 10. And like a monkey trying to fuck a... He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. First down and 5. And he runs it for 4 yards. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And that's just a great run for a touchdown.
Why didn't the skeleton dance at the rock club, Grim?
I don't know.
He had no body to dance with. That's a pretty good one.
It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's 1st and 10. Another loser bites the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's 1st and 10. Somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the 3rd set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pick, and this ref is definitely on the take. That was a bogus penalty. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile. A big gain. You know the defense wants some payback after that. 2nd down and 9. 2 minutes left in the game.
Thank God I gotta take a wicked dump. Feel like I'm sitting on a wax candle.
Not on my shoulder, you know.
2nd down and 9. Bertha, this guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim.
Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first timeout.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. Talk about butterfly. Oh. He did not see that coming, partner.
Yeah, now the ground crew's gotta come out and pick him up. Him dying really kills the momentum.
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. That's a bad kick, and it's going to cost them some yards. The onside kick is a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a possession.
Stealing ain't right, Grim. It just ain't right.
He runs it for three. And it's first and ten. The roid rage dirty trick transforms a player into a rampaging lunatic for the duration of the... And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sick.
It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
How many times?
Oh, man, he really wants it.
And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first. The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first, and they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! It should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The kicker's going to have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. was away from that tackle. And it's first and 10. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 6. And the Eagles take the win. They come up big today with a solid win, and the opposition will be licking their wounds on the long plane ride home.
My own wounds taste just like chicken. How is it Scrambles tomato soup? I forget, but a good scab tastes like bacon. That I know.
Mm-mm, a scab lettuce tomato sandwich. Sounds like a picnic. And the MVP is about to inspire us with some words of wisdom. Once again, the folks at Evil SM thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment.